Hey everybody, today we're going to talk about properties of multiplication. First, let's discuss what is multiplication. Well, if you look at the slide that's next to me, you will notice that we are adding groups of pennies. We have a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 groups of 2 pennies apiece, which makes a total of 10 cents. But a shortcut would be to say that there are 5 times 2 cents each would be also 10 cents. So what we're trying to say is that multiplication is nothing more than repeated addition, just adding the same group over and over and over again. So on this next slide, if it says to rewrite each statement using multiplication, in step A, there are 1, 2, 3, 4 fives, so that would be 4 times 5. Okay, and the next group, there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 groups of 10, which would be 9 times 10. So when you talk about vocabulary, that is one of the most important things when you're doing math, is to know what the vocabulary is. All of the things that you see on this slide, 2 with the X, which is the times sign, 3 equals 6, 2 parentheses, 3, and 2 with the dot and 3, all of that shows multiplication. The 2 and the 3 that are being multiplied together are called factors. The answer 6 that you get is called product. And then there are some words that tell you in word problems what multiplication means. Times, by, of, things like that. Okay, what we're going to do next is talk about some of the properties of multiplication. And to do that, I have some stuff on the board that I'm going to show you. So the first thing that we want to do is talk about the commutative property. Commuting is kind of like going back and forth to work or going back and forth to school. When you do this, you make a one trip and then you come back home. And it doesn't matter, it's still the same amount of miles. In math, when you're doing multiplication, it's the same process as with addition. 2 times 3 is the same answer as 3 times 2, okay? So 2 times 3, that would be 2 groups of 3. So 1, 2, 3, and 1, 2, 3, that would be 6. Over here, you have 3 groups of 2. 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. That still gives you a total of 6. So with the commutative property, the numbers, no matter what order they're in, will give you the same answer. The next property is called the associative property. And the way I view this is, you have the number 2 right here in the middle. You will notice that the order of these numbers are still the same. 5, 2, 1 on the left, 5, 2, 1 on the right. The only thing that changes is the parentheses, and there, that is the grouping symbol. First, I say that person 2 is talking to person 5. So I have 5 times 2, which would make 10. And then we get our answer and multiply times 1. Well, 10 times 1 is still 10. Over here on the other side, what's in parentheses? Now this 2 is multiplied to this 1 first. Well, 2 times 1 is 2, but then we multiply to the 5 and we still get 10. So math also has associative property with addition as well as multiplication. Then we have the identity property. And what is the identity property? Identity means you get the identical thing back when you do multiplication. And the multiplication identity is 1, because 2 times 1 is 2. And no matter what you do times 1, you still get that same identical thing back, which is why it's called the identity property. Then you have the property of 0, and that means any number times 0 gives you 0, no matter how big or small the number is. And then the last property, probably the most used property in math, is called the distributive property. Distribute is kind of like you're standing at the end of a row and you want to pass papers out to your friends. So you want to make sure that every person in the parentheses gets your papers. So that would be 5 times 2, that's what that means, and then 5 times 3. An order of operations says that you do multiplication first, so that would be 5 times 2 would be 10. 10 plus 5 times 3 would be 15, which gives you a total of 25. Now, that is all I have to say about these properties, and you need to study these to do your self-assessment in the next section.